Hello, friends and family. Another heavy topic that the Holy Spirit laid on my heart to get out to you. The Bible says that the truth will set you free. And I really feel the Father's heart. He's very hurt by the fact that the enemy steals, kills, and destroys, but then twists the truth, and then we end up blaming God. Being a deliverance minister, I run into demons all the time. We confront them, you know, and over and over and over, we get the same confirmations, okay? So I want to bring you the truth. This is a very heavy subject. Again, I just got to be obedient to the Holy Spirit. 40-year-olds, 50-year-olds, even 60-year-olds weep from the pain of being molested or sexually abused at a young age. And they've been Christians for most of their lives, and they weep and weep just like it happened a day ago. Okay? Time does not heal. All right? That's a lie. Jesus heals. All right? The truth will set us free. So that's the reason why I'm doing this video, is because I really feel a burden from the Holy Spirit to tell you that it's the enemy. Okay? The enemy stole from you. And I'm going to discuss why. All right? So what is a lie? So you got molested. Horrible, evil thing that happened to you. Disgusting. I'm sorry. My heart goes out to you. Like the abortion video, you had an abortion, Molested comes in and starts killing your children after that, the ones that you want to keep, or major health issues or female issues. And then Satan is whispering in your ear saying, look, God doesn't forgive you. God is doing this to you. God is, you know, trying to strip you. All those lies, okay? That's not the case. The case is with that abortion thing is that Molech comes in and it's a demon, a very powerful demon that is destroying your children, okay? This is truth, okay? This is the word of God. We worship Jesus Christ. We worship in spirit and in truth, all right? Yes, this isn't our God, but this leads us to Jesus, all right? And this is what combats the enemy. If you don't know this, and if you're ignorant to what is in this, I hate to be straightforward with you, but I have to be, because I'm trying to speak to you in love. But if you're ignorant of this, it's not an excuse. It's not. If Satan lies to you and you believe it, you have to take accountability for that. You have to take responsibility for that. Okay? So what is the lie? You get molested. The lie is from Satan, directly from Satan, directly from the pit of hell. God allowed this. How can God allow a 4-year-old or a 3-year-old to be molested by his own parents, to be molested by her brothers, to be molested by her uncle or the babysitter? Okay, how can God allow this? I was only 4 years old. I was only 7 years old. I was only 11 years old. Okay, that is a lie, all right? And you maybe have given your life to God and become a Christian, and in the back of your mind, there's only so far that you can get with God, because in the back of your mind, it's like, I'm serving a God who people tell me is all loving, but yet he allowed this horrible thing that happened in my life. Okay? So I'm trying to help you. I want to set you free from this lie and from these demons that has encroached on your relationship with God. And on behalf of God, God is hurt by this. Okay? God is hurt by this, that the enemy comes in and steals from you and destroys you, and you blame God for that. That hurts the Father's heart. Okay, so let me explain. There are spiritual rules that God has set up, okay? And they're all in here. Spiritual rules. Okay, God's word is his word. He cannot break his word. So here's the truth. If I, as a Christian, if I wanted to go have sex with a prostitute, I can do that. Okay? I go out, I commit adultery, I have sex with a prostitute, and if I have sex with one prostitute, I can get herpes. Okay? I'm not trying to be gross, I'm just trying to make a point. I can have sex with 99 prostitutes and not get herpes, but then the 100th time, I get herpes. Okay? So once I get herpes, do I blame God? Is that fair to blame God? And I know you're screaming at the screen right now. I was 4 years old, right? I understand. I'll get to it. Please have patience. My heart goes out to you, okay? Just bear with me. We just have to move through a little through the pain, okay? Because I want to get to the healing on the other side. I'm not just here to stir up your pain and your sorrow. I'm here because I love you, okay? And God loves you, and He wants to have that relationship with you, and not to have in the back of your mind that He's the one that caused the molestation. So if I got herpes, is it fair to blame God for that? No, and nobody does that. No, everybody understands that they're accountable for their sin. They went out, they messed up, and therefore they, you know, it's on them. Even then, though, if you repent, I do believe that herpes can be healed, okay? It's not, you know, you have to suffer that consequence for the rest of your life. Side point. Okay, so you're yelling at the screen saying you're 4 years old, you didn't sin. You know, how could you have sinned? You're innocent, and they molested you. I get that. Okay, so now I want to get into generational curse. Deuteronomy 23:2, there's what's called the bastard curse, or if there's a child in incest or a child that's born out of wedlock, there's a curse of 10 generations. The other curse is Deuteronomy 5:9, which is a curse that God will visit the iniquities of the forefathers to third and fourth generations. I've discussed this point. I don't want to rehash it. But a curse is basically a demonic assignment against you. All right, that's what a curse is. Jesus Christ became a curse for us and was crucified on a tree outside of the city. He became a curse for us. So we have the power to break the curse. Okay, we have the power to break the curse, but we have to do it, all right? It's just not going to happen automatically. Now, the whole generational curse thing, it's not taught. It's not very common knowledge, all right? Again, it is in here, okay? Ignorance is not an excuse. The whole reality of the spiritual realm continues to go on whether you believe it or not. The reality of the spiritual realm goes on whether you know the rules or not, okay? So generational curses are real. Demons are passed down through the bloodline. So you're 4 years old. You didn't sin. You didn't deserve to have a person molest you. I understand that. But you also didn't deserve to have baldness passed down to you, right? It wasn't your fault. Or it wasn't your fault to get blonde hair from your father and mother either. Okay? And spiritual giftings. Maybe your mom is a prophetess, and so you have received that prophetic gift. It actually may even be stronger than what your mom had. So you get the good stuff, but unfortunately you also get the bad stuff. Guys, blood. That is the reason why there's so many rules against blood. Don't drink it, drain the blood. You know, Jesus Christ's blood is the most powerful thing we have in the whole universe, right? It has the power to not only cover our sins, but take them away. So Satanism understands the power of the blood. That's why voodoo, they'll kill a chicken and rub the blood on you. That's why you know, Satanists, human sacrifices, they drink it. There's some horrible things that I run into quite often that your ancestors have done 3, 4, even 10 generations ago, and there's a demon in this guy or girl that they didn't know anything about it. They just knew that they've had these issues all their life. And they just thought it was normal or hereditary. But in all actuality, your ancestors made a choice for you, a choice to serve the devil, or even make a pact with the devil. Say, hey, devil, I will make a pact with you. I'll give you my soul if you give me power, if you give me wealth, if you give me protection. All right? Your ancestors come from Africa, from Haiti, from the deep south. You know, who knows? You know, a lot of you, there could be sexual perversion and molestation in your own mom and dad, but they, you know, they might even keep that from you. You know, I mean, what family dinner says, hey, yeah, you know, I was molested, you know, when I was 4. So here's the thing. Sexual perversion demon, right? Let's say in your ancestral line, through the bloodline, there was a sexual perversion demon that came into your ancestral line, whether they invited in or whether somebody was molested in your bloodline, okay? That gets passed down to the next generation, to the next generation, to the next generation. All right, this is a real live demon. It's not just a theory. It's not just a thing. This is a real life entity that is smarter than you and I, okay? It's been around for a very long time. It wants to stay in your bloodline. It will do everything it can to stay in your bloodline. And how does it do that? It tempts, it lies, it deceives, it calls to other demons, okay? I personally had a sexual perversion demon. I understand what it's like to have a sexual perversion demon handed down to me from my parents, okay? Before I knew all this deliverance stuff and what it was and all this stuff, I would be in a room and I could sense, right? I could sense somebody else in the room, crowded room, that had a familiar spirit to me, a sexual drive, connection, all right? What that was my familiar spirit that was passed down to me that I've known my whole life, okay? Because it's been in my lineage for 2, 3, 4, 5 generations, been passed down to me. I've known it since I was born. That's how I feel. That's what is natural to me, but it's really not natural. So somebody else has a sexual perversion demon, and they call to one another, all right? It can happen in the spiritual realm on the good side, too. If you guys have the same calling or this Holy Spirit, you can tell there's a Christian across in the park. Same thing. Now, I'm going to be open and honest with you guys. I've never been tempted with homosexuality, but sexual perversion is sexual perversion, okay? So it's like gaydar, you know, or everybody's like, oh, that guy's gay, you know, I have good gaydar. No, you have a sexual perversion demon that recognizes another sexual perversion demon. I don't have to commit homosexuality. Sexual perversion is sexual perversion, okay? So if you have a sexual perversion demon that's been passed down to a kid, that demon doesn't care how old you are. Demons do not play fair. Satan does not play fair. All right? So that demon will call out to another sexual perversion demon, a pedophile demon, a molestation demon. Okay, and it could have been your own uncle. So your own uncle got the same demon that you have. And so it's the same demon that's in your uncle is attracted to the demon that's in you. And if your sexual perversion demon calls out to another person and that person and you get molested, then there's another transfer that's there too. You can get that new sexual perversion demon. It's nasty, guys. It's nasty. You need to get rid of that demon. You need to forgive your molester. That is not an option. I know what they did to you was horrendous. It is not an option not to forgive them. Okay? Matthew 18. God forgave you for a lot more. All right? Forgive your molester, and you have to get deliverance. But the bottom line is, it wasn't God allowing you to be molested. It wasn't God turning his back on you and allowing you to be molested, okay? There are rules. There's people who serve the enemy and who don't use their authority in Jesus Christ to cast out devils, heal the sick in their own lives, all right? It's not that they want to serve the devil. It's just they're ignorant to the power and the authority that they have. And so they struggle with life. They just feel like sexual perversion, struggling with sexual perversion is just a normal way of life because nobody taught them any different because it was handed down to them from their father and mother. And so they just go through life like, oh yeah, I struggle with this, you know, and they never get delivered. And then they pass it down to you. And so when you're 4 years old, it was passed to you down at conception. Okay. So when you're 4 years old, that demon's been in your life for 4 years. And if it sees another sexual perversion demon, that demon wants to stay in your lineage. And so it will cause the same sin to happen. So it stays another 3 to 4 generations. Does that make sense? And if you cast out that demon, then that demon gets punished because it failed its assignment. It failed its curse. If that curse was broken, it failed. Okay. And if someone curses you, and you break that curse, and that demon goes back to sender. All right? There's just rules, guys. Like I said, if I had sex with a prostitute, I get herpes. I don't blame God and saying, God turned his back on me, and I hate him. How can a loving God allow me to get herpes? It was my fault. I served my own flesh. I served my own demons. I opened the door to a demonic being. And it's caused this in my life, okay? I know you're 4 years old, 7 years old. You were innocent. I understand that. But you were given underneath the covering of your father and mother. And if they were ignorant of the demonic realm, and they all their demons were passed down to you, that's not your fault either. It could be seven generations ago, but it just kept on passing down because that demon wants to perpetuate the sin in the next generation. And so they get that person to be sexually perverted. And then it gives them another permission to go three or four generations more. And then that demon causes them to be sexually perverted. It goes down three or four generations. Understand? And like I said, there's a lot, I'm running a little late, but there's a lot of demons that have a lot of roles, a lot of responsibilities. There's demons that just call out to other demons. Hey, come attack this person. There's demons that their job is to open the door to other demons. There's demons that confuse, cause unbelief, cause cancer. But their end goal is to steal, kill, and destroy. That's it. And then to lie to you and say, well, it's God's fault, which is basically your only source of help and rescue. They're trying to cut you off from the lifeline. It's Jesus that's going to come and heal that wound. He's also given us the keys to the kingdom. You know, we have to walk in authority. He's given us the keys to the tank, the Abrams tank. You know, we have to jump in. We have to read the manual, you know, to know how to run the tank. Another note, there's a demon called Ashtaroth that I ran into that is a sexual abuse demon. And in the Old Testament, there are Ashtaroth poles. And in my opinion, they're basically phallic symbols. It wouldn't surprise me. And so, you know, the Washington Monument and the Vatican Tower or whatever it's called, and these little monuments, tower, phallic symbols all over the country. You know, it doesn't surprise me. There's a bunch of pedophilia going on in the Catholic Church. Well, they got they have an Ashtaroth pole that they basically honor or worship or whatever they have it, you know, what that has to do with the Bible. Why is it in their courtyard at the Vatican? But, you know, it doesn't surprise me that if they have an Ashtaroth pole, which is a sexual abuse demon, and it doesn't surprise me that pedophilia runs rampant. I'm going to do a video very, very soon, hopefully within the next 3 days, of giving you guys more resources on where to find deliverance ministers in your area. That's probably the number one question I get is, hey, I live outside the United States, or I live over here. Where can I find a minister? So I'm gonna give out more resources. I love you guys. I'm sorry this is a hard message again. But the enemy comes in, steals, kills, and destroys, and then makes you blame God, which is your only rescue. You know, Jesus Christ wants to come in, and I've seen some amazing testimonies where Jesus Christ comes into that pain and heals it right away. Okay. If you won't mind, let's just pray. Jesus Christ is the one that's going to heal you, not me yapping. The truth will set you free, but let's put the truth into action. So I'm going to pray as the victim. So you can either agree with me or, you know, repeat after me, or just listen and later on pray it from your own heart. All right. Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, I choose to forgive my molester, my rapist, the person who betrayed me. Father, I choose to forgive them and I bless them. Lord, I ask that you protect victims from them, but I ask that you deliver them as well and provide them healing as well. Lord, I choose to forgive you. I blamed you for all these years for causing the molestation in my life, or the rape in my life, or the sexual abuse in my life. God, it's not your fault. Lord, it's the enemy's fault. And Father God, I pray that you give me a righteous anger towards the enemy, where it needs to be, not on you. Father God, you are my healer and my comforter and my savior. Lord, please forgive me for holding this burden and this bitterness and this anger towards you and towards my attacker. God, I bless your name. But forgive me for holding this lie for so long. And I thank you that you revealed the truth to me. And Lord Jesus Christ, I ask you to come and bind up my heart. When this happened, it was a horrible thing for me. And Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, if this sexual perversion demon is in me, Lord, if I have committed sin of what this sexual perversion demon wanted me to commit, forgive me of lust, forgive me of sexual perversion, forgive me of adultery, forgive me of homosexuality, forgive me of pedophilia, forgive me of molestation. Lord, I renounce this curse in my life. Lord, forgive me and my ancestors for engaging with this sexual perversion demon in the first place. Forgive us of this sin. And right now I separate myself from this generational curse in the name of Jesus Christ. And sexual perversion demon, all sexual perversion demons, I bind you together as one in the name of Jesus Christ. And you just heard me confess of these sins. And so therefore you now have no legal right. And if my children are under the age of accountability, I command in the name of Jesus Christ that you come out of them, and I bind you as one in me now. And I bind you as one in the name of Jesus Christ. I cast you all out into the abyss, never to return. Go now. Jesus Christ, please come. Please heal my pain, my memory, my wounds. I ask for your healing. Thank you for leading me into truth. I pray that you've finished the work that you've started in me. And if I need more deliverance, please, Lord, let me know and guide me to where I can get help. I love you. I'm thankful that our relationship can be clean and I can get as closest to you as I want without this lie in between us. Amen. Love you guys.